Hi everyone, this is Sainath. Today let us start another class in polity series, that is part 2 of the Constitution of India, that is citizenship. In India there are two kinds of people, citizens of India and aliens. Citizens are those people who enjoy all the civil and political rights. Aliens, they do not enjoy all civil and political rights. Aliens are of two kinds, that is friendly aliens and enemy aliens. Friendly aliens are the citizens of another country who have cordial or good relations with India, and enemy aliens are the citizens of that country which had war with India. According to Constitution of India, the following rights are available for only citizen of India and not for aliens, that is Article 15, 16, 19, 29, 30. Now let us see the articles. Article 15, prohibition of discrimination on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth. And Article 16, equality of opportunity in matter of public employment. And 19, protection of certain rights regarding freedom of speech, expression, assembly, association, movement, residence, and profession. Now Article 29, protection of interests of minorities. Now Article 30, right of minorities to establishment and administer the educational institution. Not only the above rights, but also aliens do not have the following: right to vote in Lok Sabha and state legislative assembly, right to contest in parliament and state legislative assembly. And they are also, the aliens are also not eligible for post of President of India, Vice President of India, Judge of Supreme Court, High Court, Attorney General of India, Advocate General of India. Now let us see the articles from 5 onwards. The Article 5 says that citizenship at the commencement of the Constitution, the people who was born in territory of India, either of his parents were born in territory of India, who has been ordinary resident in territory of India for not less than 5 years immediately preceding such commencement, okay, these people shall be a citizen of India. Now Article 6, rights of citizenship of certain persons who have migrated to India from Pakistan. Here there are two clauses. He or either of his parents or any of his grandparents was born in India as defined in the Government of India Act 1935, which is undivided India, okay? And in case where such person has so migrated before 19th July and resident in territory of India since the date of migration, and he has been now settled in India, okay? In case where such persons have so migrated on after 19th July 1948, should be registered by a government officer and should be residing in India, okay? Provided that no person shall be so registered unless he has been resident in territory of India for last 6 months immediately preceding the date of his application. Now let us see Article 7, rights of citizenship of certain migrants to Pakistan. People who migrated after 1st March 1947 from territory of India to territory of Pakistan shall not be citizens, okay? Provided after having so migrated to territory, now include in Pakistan, that is in Pakistan, has returned to India for resettlement, should take permanent resident issued by the government of India, okay? Article 8, right of citizenship of certain persons of India or Indian origin residing outside India, okay? Any person who are either whose parents are one of the grandparents was born in India in a combined India, that is India before 1947, is who is ordinarily residing in any country outside India So defined shall be deemed to citizen of India if he has resided, if he registered as a citizen of India by diplomat of the government of India outside that country. Article 9. Persons voluntarily acquiring citizenship of foreign state not be citizen. If a person from India acquired the citizenship of the another country, he shall be deemed not to be the citizen of India. Article 10. Continuance of rights of citizenship. Every person who is a citizen of India shall act according to the laws of the Indian Constitution and Indian so. Article 11. Parliament to regulate the right of citizenship by law. Any citizen or citizen of India should be respect to the acquisition and termination of citizen and all matters relating to citizenship. Okay. Acquisition of citizenship. Citizenship by birth. A person born in India on or after 26th January 1950 but before 1st July 1987 is a citizen of India irrespective of nationality of his parents. After 1st July 1987, a person considered as a citizen of India only if either of his parents is a citizen of India at the time of his birth. After 3rd December 2004, the person is considered as a citizen of India only if both the parents are citizen of India or one parent is citizen of India and other is not illegal migrant. Now citizenship by descent. Descent. A person born outside India on or after 26th Jan 1950 but before 10th December 1992 is considered to be a citizen of India if his father was citizen of India. After 10th December 1992, he is considered to be a citizen of India if either of his parents is citizen of India at the time of his birth. From 3rd December 2004, he is considered to be a citizen of India. From 3rd December 2004, he is considered to be a citizen of India. His birth should be registered within 1 year of the date of birth or with the permission of the central government after the time has expired. Now citizenship by registration. A person can be a citizen of India by registration and it includes the following. A person of Indian origin who is ordinarily residing in India for 7 years before making application. Okay. A person of Indian origin who is ordinarily resident in any country or place outside the undivided India. A person who is married to a citizen of India and is ordinarily resident in India for 7 years before making application for registration. Minor child of a person who are citizens of India. A person of full age and capacity whose parents are registered as a citizen of India. A person of full age and capacity who or either of his parents was earlier citizen of India and he has been residing in India for 1 year immediately before making application. A person of full age and capacity who has been registered as an overseas citizen of India for 5 years and who has been residing in India for 1 year before making the application. Citizenship by naturalization. Citizenship of in India by naturalization can be acquired by foreigners who is ordinarily residing in India for 12 years and other qualification as specified in the third schedule of Citizens Act. And loss of citizenship. Loss of citizenship can be three types: by renunciation, by termination, by deprivation. By renunciation, if the citizen of India voluntarily renounces, he is deemed to be not to be the citizen of India. By termination, When an Indian citizen voluntarily acquires the citizenship of another country, his Indian citizenship automatically terminates. Okay? By deprivation. It is a compulsorily termination of Indian citizenship by central government if the followings are there. The citizen has obtained the citizenship by fraud. The citizen has shown disloyalty to Constitution of India. The citizen has unlawful trade or communicated with enemies during war. The citizen has within 5 years after registration or naturalization been imprisoned in any other country for 2 years. The citizen has been ordinarily residing out of India for 7 years continuously. Okay. This was a video for Polity series, and there are much more videos to come. Thank you. Thank you for watching.